This HB 41, your home of the Kansas City Chiefs. Today, the Chiefs will hold their first full squad practice at training camp in St. Joe. Today's practice only open to season ticket holders. Tomorrow is the first day that it's open to the general public. My co-anchor Taylor Hemnes live at Missouri Western State University just hours before the guys hit the field. Good morning, Taylor. Football's back.
That's right, Lindsay. Good morning. Glad to have football back here in St. Joseph for training camp. You're right. The players not out here just yet. The college football players out here warming up and have been since before the sun came up. But the Chiefs are not out here just yet. They'll be out here later in the morning. You know, if you think about last season, it's kind of wild the NFL was able to have a season at all in the middle of pandemic. Pretty amazing they were able to go through the entire season. The Chiefs had been able to play all their games. But one thing that was not able to be salvageable in the middle of all that pandemic was traditional training camp. The Chiefs, of course, staying in Kansas City last year. That meant not a trip to San Joe and no fans able to attend. That was a big bummer for a lot of people. But this year they're back. Fans able to come back. I reached out on social media this week and asked Chiefs fans to send me some of their favorite moments, their favorite memories from training camps past. And I got some great responses. I want to show you some photos this morning from Brian Edelman. He's one of the guys that tweeted at me and sent me some photos. He snagged selfies with Travis Kelce, longtime punter Dustin Colquitt, you'll see in here, even Patrick Mahomes. He told me that that day they didn't have anything for Patrick to sign, but Patrick walked right up to them on the autograph line, and so he just asked if he could take a selfie. And got one. Maybe the best photo he sent to me, though, is proving how much of a fan he is. It's a photo that he has of his young son, Andy, just born last year. Yeah, named after head coach Andy Reid. That's where the Andy comes from. So absolutely a huge fan. They're from Iowa and big, big fans of the Chiefs there in Iowa, getting ready to come to training camp, hopefully again this year. I also heard from a family in Nebraska who reached out to me because they have made coming to training camp a family affair now for several years. And because of that, they've had some really cool moments. Check it out.
What's your best memory, any of you, of training camp? Like, what's the most, like, you'll never believe this happened to me at Chiefs training camp?
Right over my shoulder here. And this shoulder here too. So these jerseys behind us are Mahomes and Kelce, and got pictures and a video of Mahomes and pictures of both of them signing the jerseys while the kids were wearing them.
Yeah, while he was on Dad's shoulder, he's getting a signature from the Chiefs superstar. The boys have been to lots of training camps over the years. 8-year-old Callan showed me his move to try and get players' attention at the autograph line.
Do you have like a move that you do to get their attention? How do you get these autographs to be around some of these guys? What's it been like?
This.
Sometimes it works. And they know what they're looking for during practice, too.
I like when the defense tries to get past the offense and the offense tries to stop the defensive lineman. I always like watching the quarterback's foot movement and arm movement and decision making because I study it and it helps me become a better player.
So even though they won't be able to get quite so close to the players this year, this fan family still pumped to come back to St. Joe.
So obviously fans and families all across Chiefs Kingdom thrilled that they're able to come back and be part of training camp again here in St. Joe. St. Joseph itself also very excited those people are coming back. Please pardon the sun rising over St. Joseph behind Charlie Keegan and I this morning. You talked to some of the visitors in Convention Bureau here in St. Joe. They missed out a lot last year.
They really did miss out last year, and they're really ready to welcome Chiefs fans back here to St. Joseph and kind of make up for lost time in healthy, safety, and safe ways. I want to show you what it looks like around town. Just as you drive through St. Joseph, you're going to notice all sorts of these little yard signs along the main streets and in front of other attractions that say, Welcome Chiefs. So they are really rolling out the red carpet for these fans. And the Convention and Visitors Bureau, it's their job now to make sure that they're helping Chiefs fans really turn their trip up here to visit practice into a day trip where they can also check out a museum, check out a shop, visit downtown and some restaurants, things like that. Here's what the Convention Visitors Bureau Director of Communications talked to me about.
You can tell when it's training camp time because a lot of the visitors are wearing the red, so they're pretty identifiable. But museums do see a definite uptick because of Chiefs camp.
All right, and get your red for Friday's Red Rally, a pep rally event in downtown St. Joseph that the Visitors Bureau
put on. Can I bring my big flag? Is that okay? Is that welcome?
I'll bring my little flag. You bring your big one, and yeah, we'll have some fun.
I stole this one from my house front door. That's why normally that's what I would have on my desk too. Right. But I stole this one from the house this morning.
Right.
Really, they've got to be pumped to have people back.
Oh, really looking forward to it. Yes, yeah. And eager to regain this tradition.
Absolutely. So a lot of fans and the city itself and, of course, the Chiefs thrilled to be back here in St. Joe for the return of training camp. No autographs. We need to keep reminding that. No autographs this year to keep everyone safe, but fans still able to come and watch. Season ticket holders today. Lindsay, back to you.